So what I just found out is actually quite shocking, but it does reveal a lot about the meat industry. So please stay to the end of the video because you're going to want to hear this. I also just want to mention this video will not be graphic, although I will be talking about some graphic things. I will link all the graphic footage I'm referencing down below. So if you haven't already heard, we recently left cameras in a slaughterhouse called C.J Byford and Sons in Essex. This was in around February this year. I decided to go down to the slaughterhouse after I witnessed what was in the footage, and it was quite disturbing. Just to see what the slaughterhouse owners might say about their business and how they conduct themselves around animals, I expected a bunch of lies and propaganda. But it turned out much more interesting than I anticipated, and I ended up making a 30-minute video about the whole discussion and put all of the investigation footage inside of that discussion to juxtapose what the industry tell people and what reality looks like. A very shocked meat eater actually watched the video and contacted the slaughterhouse, and the slaughterhouse owner responded and called the video doctored vegan propaganda. It was her son who was doing the torturing and killing, and the slaughterhouse were kind of backed into a corner, and this was one of their only ways out. So the slaughterhouse got over 300 bad Google reviews after the video. Their website was even hacked with the Dominion documentary, so when people clicked on their website, they'd go straight to the Dominion doc. And because of all the heat, they removed themselves off of Google. Another activist in the movement, Holly, started a petition to get C.J. Byford and Sons shut down, which now has over 80,000 signatures. Plant-based News have reported on this as well. And the local media, the Clacton Gazette, contacted me about the story. I had a 15-minute discussion with the journalist, and one of the things the journalist told me is that the Association of Independent Meat Suppliers said to look at my criminal history and that I obtained the footage illegally and basically used my past as a reason to justify what was in that footage. I was also contacted by the Food Standards Agency. They kind of enforce all the standards in slaughterhouses. I sent them the raw footage. They said they would take it very seriously. And just this morning, the article has been published. So let's go through it together. So it says a petition calling for a slaughterhouse in Little Clacton to be shut down has attracted more than 80,000 signatures. The petition was launched after a COVID video was recorded at C.J. Byford and Sons slaughterhouse in Lodge Lane by Australian YouTube campaigner Joey Carbstrong. Joey, whose channel has more than 150,000 subscribers, confronted the owners of the slaughterhouse after making this recording. Those signing the petition are concerned about how cows have been treated. But, listen to this, after reviewing the footage, the Food Standards Agency said it has not found any breaches of animal welfare legislation. How about that? So what the FSA are saying, after reviewing the footage, that everything that happened in that footage is completely, legally fine. What an absolute joke. So if anyone's seen that footage, you'll know how shocking and disgraceful what happened in that footage was. But the FSA are saying, no, it's completely legal. So here we see the obvious contrast between what is legal and what is moral. Let's not forget, the Holocaust was completely legal. Slavery in America was completely legal. Slaughtering animals is completely legal. And what happened in that footage is completely legal. Does that mean it's ethical? No. Joey said, we thought we'd find dairy cows being slaughtered, but it was beef cattle. Lots of people think that because it's a local family-owned spot, that it's somehow different to other slaughterhouses. We wanted to dispel that. I had a 15-minute conversation with Dammy, explaining what was in the footage, what happened to the cows, debunking some of the claims from Association of Independent Meat Suppliers. They haven't included none of that. They haven't even included the name of the video so people can go and review the footage. I assume Dammy has reviewed the footage themselves, but what they do go on to do is give the industry most of the article to respond. So let's go. It says, Kevin Mayer, head of animal welfare at the Food Standards Agency, said, the FSA has a zero tolerance approach to animal welfare breaches and all staff are instructed to take prompt enforcement action where they are identified. We have staff present during processing at slaughterhouses and CCTV is mandatory in England as part of stronger measures to prevent animal welfare incidences. This is just a standard industry line. Like we take animal welfare very seriously, and we have a zero tolerance approach to it, and we have staff present at all slaughterhouses and CCTV. Yeah, but what happened in the footage still happened, didn't it? And you're saying it's completely legal. So why do we care about what the FSA have to say in terms of ethics when what we saw in that footage were cows bellowing out after being stunned and then having their head cut off while they're still flailing around, okay? This guy grabbing the cow by the face, swearing at him, bolting him in the skull, a cow struggling for about 40 seconds trying to escape the knockbox, ripping their own horns off in the process, and the FSA are saying, Well, it's totally legally fine. The majority of non-compliances do not involve animals experiencing avoidable pain, distress, or suffering. However, the FSA takes action in response to all non-compliances to avoid more serious issues occurring and to protect animal welfare. This is just industry talk, industry language. How the hell is this not a non-compliance? That's what I want to know. The animal's obviously in fear, distress, and suffering. How you can decapitate a cow that's still moving and claim that they're unconscious? Like, I just don't get that either. Like, this is what I mean. Like, if you want to listen to the legal standards versus, like, using your eyes and looking at reality, then that's up to you. But I do not trust these government standards. I just don't trust them. FSA veterinarians have inspected the premises and reviewed the available footage and not identified any non-compliances with animal welfare legislation. All of you meat eaters out there, right? If you're following me, if you're watching this, just remember that the footage that I'm going to link down below is completely legally fine according to the Food Standards Agency, okay? They're veterinarians, they've reviewed the footage, they think that what this guy did to this cow is totally fine, totally legal, right? He swore at the cow, grabbed the cow by the face, bolted him, decapitated him while they're still moving, you know what I mean? Like, yeah, no worries. A cow tears their own horns off trying to escape a knot box, no worries. A brown cow just flailing around in the air, kicking and like, what the hell is that? What the hell is going on in there? You know, that this is just crazy. So people going, oh, well, like, you know, the FSA said there was nothing wrong with it, Joey. Well, look at the footage. Why would you care what they're saying? How low is the bar set for what's legally acceptable? If that's okay. This is a local family-run operation too. Just imagine what happens in the bigger places. Additionally, the FSA has reached out to the source of the footage to supply any further information, but has not yet received any response. I have responded. I responded to them the next day, and I sent them the footage. This is the email here. So this is just old information, actually. So the journalists could have updated this, but anyways, it seems to me that the journalist is doing a little bit of industry protecting himself. If anyone has a concern about animal welfare at a slaughterhouse premises, they should contact animalwelfare@food.gov.uk. There's the email. Tell them what you think of the footage in that video, okay? There's the video down there. That's what happened to the cows. This is what the guy did to the cows. This person is going to get away scot-free. Nothing is going to happen to that savage brute who was grabbing that cow by the face, swearing at him, bolting him in the head, right? Cutting their head off while they're still moving around. Nothing's going to happen to him. It's absolutely fine. Holly Garforth of Brighton EC started the petition after watching the footage online. She said, I care very much about the animals and I'm heavily invested in animal rights. Very good work, Holly, for starting that petition. And they only included one sentence of her, three sentences of me, and one sentence of Holly. Is there going to be any mention of what happened in the footage? Who wants to see me upload the full conversation with the media so you know what I said to them versus what they reported? Just so you get a good idea of whose interests this paper is protecting. The Association of Independent Meat Suppliers has issued a response following the launch of the petition. Here they are here, the Association of Independent Meat Suppliers. Their aim, defend our members' interests, put a stop to anti-industry campaigning. They're just basically here to defend slaughterhouses and put a stop to activism. Wow. We're supposed to listen to you. Is it like, so basically what you say is going to be completely unbiased. Hey, you're not just here to be a mouthpiece for the slaughterhouses, are you? Tony Goodger, communications manager, spoke on behalf of C.J. Byford and Sons. He said, the petition firstly names a legal business and provides the address for that business. We believe that this is an infringement of their rights to privacy. It's a public business. You can Google them up. You can find their address online. They're a business. Find CJ Byford & Son in Clacton-on-Sea. It's just like saying, you told us where that McDonald's was. You've breached their rights to privacy. Like, you're a bloody public operating business. Like how is that an infringement of rights? And you know what it kind of says to me? Like, you obviously don't want the public knowing where you are and what you're up to there. You want to keep your dirty little secret a dirty little secret. You don't want cameras in there. You don't want people seeing what happens to the animals in there. All of these groups, these Association of Independent Meat Suppliers and AHDB and other lobby groups like Red Tractor, they're only set up to protect the interests of their members, which are other farmers, you know, and that's it. And the public fall hook, line and sinker for it, which they've got to stop falling for all this nonsense. In the UK, all abattoirs are required by law to have a veterinary surgeon on site during the period of animal processing. If I hear that one more time, mate, my ears are going to fall off. I've heard it so many times this whole time. This vet is employed by the UK Food Standards Agency and is independent of the business processing the animals. Well, if the vet, this woman here, was present the whole time that was happening, how come she didn't intervene when he was grabbing that cow by the face? What, is that okay? Just to swear and grab a cow aggressively by the face, a cow that's obviously distressed. So in the FSA guidelines, They're supposed to make sure that the risk of any animal suffering during the process is minimized. But what you saw on that footage looked like the stress and the fear and the suffering was maximized. That's what it looked like to me. How on earth you call that an effective stun is beyond me. Like, nothing surprises me anymore. Completely legal, according to the FSA, which is what I try to tell meat eaters. They think all of this, the abuse that happens in slaughterhouses and farms, is illegal. Well, no, it's completely legally sanctioned. The whole point is, just because something's legal does not mean it's ethical. In the case of our members' business, no breaches of animal welfare legislation have ever been reported by the FSA. So this is what the industry spokespeople are saying, but what does the footage show? Check it out down there. You be the judge. Most of the filmed footage was obtained by covert filming using cameras installed on the site by animal welfare activists. Their illegal incursion onto the site was without the prior knowledge or consent of the owners of the business. It's not illegal to trespass, and of course we're going to investigate without the prior knowledge or consent of the owners of the business. Look what was happening on the inside. Do you think they're really going to act like that if they know they're being filmed? That's how investigations work. This is in the public interest, 100% in the public's interest to know what C.J. Byford and Son are doing to cows inside of their business, and that the FSA say it's completely fine and legal. And you got industry spokespeople like Association of Independent Meat Suppliers who are there to put a stop to anti-industry campaigning defending it. No worries. So you got the animal people who have the animals' interests in heart. We don't eat the animals. We don't want to use it to kill the animals. We're saying one thing. And the industry who are making money off of killing them and selling their body parts are saying another thing. Who do you trust? I wouldn't be trusting the people who are making money from their slaughter, that's for sure. The owners of C.J. Byford and Son have also reported the intrusion to Essex Police. A spokesperson for the police said, "We were called to reports of someone trespassing at a property and making threats to people there. Inquiries are ongoing." Is this in relation to when I walked onto their property to talk to the lady? Because if that is the case, I said to her, "Do you mind me being on this driveway? I can move off."
I'm pretty sure this road is public, yeah?
Excuse me, this is not there.
Oh, no. I was just, if you want me to move off of it, I can.
It's not there.
I think someone called the cops while we were there. I was not trespassing. I asked her if she would like me to move off of the driveway. She said, "No, that's fine. Just don't film." I said, "We're allowed to film in the public space. My camera person is off of your property." Did they claim that I made threats against them? Because wouldn't that be a false allegation? I wonder if it's legal to make false allegations to the police without evidence. We filmed the whole interaction too, so... that would be interesting. But I wonder if I should report to the police the animal abuse there. Oh, wait a second. They would just say, "Nah, it's completely legal. That animal abuse is completely legal. So there's no point going through the proper authorities when it comes to ethics and morality, because they don't care about that. They just care what's written in black and white. And that's the legislation that is only set up to protect those exploiting and killing the animals and does not protect the animals themselves. So my overview of this article by Dami Adewale is that it just basically defends the industry. And Dami, you should be accountable for this. You've removed so much context here. You haven't told the public what happened to the animals on the inside. You've given the industry 80% of the response. Basically, you've made us look like unreasonable, irrational people who are just complaining about nothing. If you wanted to let Dami know what you think of this article, you can go to the Clacton Gazette article. I'll leave it linked down below and leave a comment there. I think it's absolutely just, you're defending the industry and look what they're doing to the animals. You don't care about the animals. You would have reviewed the footage and it's disgusting. So how dare you make such a biased, it's a biased article, and it's omitted very key facts, which I just think is dishonest. And whoever got you to do that, Dami, why did you listen to them? So it looks like Dami's just doing what their boss tells him. I wonder who runs the Clacton Gazette and how connected they are to the industry there. Probably all meat eaters. Dami's probably just a meat eater too. It seemed like he cared about what I was saying on the phone, but judging by this article, you've chosen a side and you're definitely not on the animal side. So I'm going to read through some of the comments on this article here. Here we go, Officer Dibley. "So they have done nothing wrong, but the turd-brained vegetarians and vegans are telling lies yet again. Just because they themselves can't face eating the poor little fluffy animals. Morons." And it's got 48 likes. Insulting people calling us morons. They've done nothing wrong. Well, Officer Dibley, if you think they did nothing wrong to those animals, then maybe you wouldn't mind trading places with them. See, this is why this person who wrote this article, who did not write it in an unbiased way, it wasn't balanced at all. Now we have people thinking they've done nothing wrong. They haven't seen the footage. Just because they haven't done anything technically illegal, which is questionable anyway, doesn't mean they haven't done anything morally wrong. Look at the footage yourself. Tell me what you see. That's legal. Just because something's legal doesn't mean it's not wrong. Look back in history. Anyways, these people here, they just don't want to believe they're being lied to. They just want to hate on the vegans, don't want to look at reality, you know. And meat eaters, after seeing that footage, were sickened by it. So many people left comments saying, I'm not eating meat anymore, I'm going vegan, you know, that this is it. I got inbox from people like, that's it, I'm not eating meat anymore. It's disgusting what they're doing. Legally getting away with. Here we go, Misty. How do you know plants don't feel pain? So this is what happens when you share violent footage of animals struggling for their life in a slaughterhouse. People say, how do you know tomatoes don't feel pain? This is the level of intellect we're dealing with in society. Shame not to have included in the article a link to the original undercover footage, part of which shows an animal struggling so hard to avoid being killed, they rip a horn off. They rip both their horns off, in fact, so people can judge for themselves. I mean, why take your dog to a vet to put them down when you can just take them to a slaughterhouse and have it done humanely? Yeah, exactly. No one would want their dog going to that slaughterhouse, that's for sure. Dysfunctional England. Well done, Joey. The public needs to be made visibly aware as to how meat ended up on their plates. Looks like vegans have already found this. Go to YouTube and type Joey Carbstrong Family Slaughterhouse for the footage which the article did not link in. Distressing content? Guess I will search out the video for myself, seeing as the Echo didn't supply it. They didn't supply the video because it's very damning footage, and we're going to spread it far and wide, share it far and wide, get people watching it. I've made a shorter video down below that you can share as well. It's 6 minutes, so it just contains the slaughterhouse footage. The other video is quite long. So that was the article by the Clacton Gazette. That is the FSA's response. Nothing illegal has happened there. So this is why the power is in the hands of the consumer. You boycott these products if you want something to happen. You stop giving places like this their money. Stop paying for meat from local butchers, because this is where this happened, local butcher. Boycott meat, dairy and eggs and other animal products if you care about the interests of animals. Stop listening to those who are making financial gain from the demise of animals, because obviously they have a vested interest. The footage does not lie. Review the footage down below. Sign the petition. Don't know if the petition's going to get anywhere, but at least it creates a bit of awareness about this, and keep the heat and pressure on this slaughterhouse. Look at what they're doing to the animals. Just because that's legal doesn't mean it's okay. Shame on Dammy for this biased defense piece of the industry, defending animal abusers. You'll have to live with your own conscience for that. And please choose vegan. Help us get the message out there, and I'll see you all in the next video. Peace.